from the new definition. So before the redefinition, IPK was existing with zero uncertainty. That is, after cleaning and washing, whatever is the weight of the international prototype of kilogram is considered to be 1 kg with zero uncertainty. Now, during the measurement of Planck constant, the realization methods which were used, like Kibble balance or XRCD method, they were having some amount of uncertainty during the measurement. So now, during this transition, the uncertainty which was coming due to measurement has been shifted, transferred to the IPK. Now, after this, this happened in the first phase. Presently, we are in the second phase. Now, in the second phase, what happened is that now we have several traveling standards which are measured by the NMIs or the countries which are having the realization methods like Kibble balance or XRCD method, and their values are compared, and then a consensus value is arrived, achieved. So using that consensus value, now we are getting the traceability. I will show you the new certificate which we have received very recently. So this is how presently we are working at the apex level. I believe Dr. Davidson is going to discuss more about this when he will be talking about the traceability. So now, if I see the same traceability chart which I have shown before, so nothing has changed here from the NPK to the commercial weights. However, here we at the top we find that the traceability has started coming from the consensus value. Okay, so this slowly, this part, the IPK will be eliminated from the traceability chart when we will go to the third phase, that is the last phase, where dissemination will be by the individual realizations. Individual realization means the Kibble balance or XRCD realization method which the NMIs are developing. So till now, the traceability was coming from the IPK, which is at the IPM. However, when we will reach to the phase three, any country which is having a realization method can help in giving the traceability. So this is the change which has happened at the apex level, where we are now getting the value from the consensus value. Now, the NPK 57 has been recalibrated in November 2022, and the calibration results are now based on the consensus value of the kilogram, which is commencing from the 1st March 2023, which is the second consensus value. Now, if we see the trend, the way our national prototype of kilogram after the calibration has is changing. So when we got this value, NPK 57, we received it with 1 kg minus 0.054 as its nominal value, which was the first calibration. Now, with the subsequent calibration, we found that the value has been found to change with the subsequent calibrations. So, and then the recent calibration, which is giving us a value 1 kg minus 0.063 as its nominal value. Now, the combined uncertainty which we are getting at the moment of the mass assigned to this prototype is 0.021 mg. So for this particular NPK 57, the uncertainty is 0.021 milligram. Now, this uncertainty is dominated by the standard uncertainty of 0.020 milligram of the consensus value. So now, because this value we are getting from the consensus value, so we have to consider the uncertainty of the of this measurement also. So the uncertainty of this measurement is again 0.02.